All right, hey, Josh here, out here in Ohio here. Hey, in this video here, this is actually, check this out, 22 by 48. Now, this is a carriage style barn. It's gonna have a loft to it. I wanna highlight just a few different things on this. You can see this is a 12-12 pitch, pretty tall here. This is built, you probably can see in the background here with the houses, but built in a pretty tight residential neighborhood. Almost kind of like a Wrigley Field feel here. Very tight house on top of each other. But anyway, you can see here, 12-12 pitch on the trusses. Couple different things. Since we're on the trusses, let's talk about really these trusses, okay? You can see the bottom cord. See that bottom cord right there? Now this is a scissor style truss. You can see that's a 2x6 bottom cord. That's an MSR lumber species. So what that is called machine stress rated, meaning that it's been tested to be stronger than a normal SPF. Well, it's SPF lumber, but it's been stress tested. And then you can see the top cord, and you can see that a 2x4 top cord on this truss. So that kind of gives you an idea, 12-12 pitch, but 22x48. And then I'll show you what they chose to use here for their post selection here. They chose green post, and this is kind of a new, let's go over here, I'll show you, kind of give you a little bit better angle on this. But these green posts right here, you can see what it is. It's a 3-ply laminated column wrapped in a green post. Okay, so the 3-ply again, 2x6s, yellow pine, glued, laminated together. See that pressure point there? You've got a pressure point there, and then you also have a pressure point right there as well. But what these green posts do, okay, it's like asphalt, all right? And this is kind of a newer thing that's out on the market there. You can see there what it does. The concept behind this is obviously to take away from post rot. Definitely makes sense, but you can see it burns the asphalt right in there. And there's a lot of different technicality ingredients in there. But it's a green post, and from the cost effectiveness, it's a little bit more than a standard 3-ply, because you're adding a little bit of a labor and a little bit of thing to it. But it's a green post. And again, we can dig down here, 54 inches here. This is Ohio, 54 inches, frost line 42 inches. Then we set this on a cookie, a concrete cookie. Then we backfill it. You can see this berm right here, not dirt, but this is a 411 base right here. You see that stone? You can see it's got a sandy mix, almost like a highway stone. And the reason for that is you backfill it with that, that way water can really move down there. Then also down in that post, we have 2x6s going east and west, and then also north and south for uplift protection to keep this building from obviously coming up. So there you go there. So early stages here, you see it's gonna be a nice little building here. A couple carve out here, overhead doors here on the east side as well, but there's gonna be a nice loft up here. So here's what you can do if you're in town thinking, okay, oh my, I want a stick frame maybe. Well, here's what you can do with the post frame. So stick frame, post frame, you can make things definitely work. But keep following the journey, AtticaLumber.com.